had a meeting with some of the organizers of the demonstrations and the rally. Definitely with the mosques, and that's why I also sent a message to them at the beginning of the rally.
For some of us, since so many demonstrations, rallies, strikes, do you think this was different to the extent that is it an exaggeration that people are saying this is likely to be some spring or Hamatan or whatever name it is called?
But there's no question at all about it that we're witnessing something really historic and enormous. It is, of course, a very logical expansion of previous demonstrations and rallies. These things surmount one another as frustrations grow, as anger grows, so does the will of the people advance. The level of anger and frustration which we're witnessing today has been long in coming. And so no one should be surprised that we're seeing a level of persistence that we're not accustomed to. So this is very different. This is a watershed in the expression of popular will. No question at all about that.
So they removed petroleum subsidy, as they have said, but there's been a lot of argument, Prof, that there is no subsidy, there's no subsidizing of petroleum products, or even gasoline, as we call petrol in Nigeria. Was just the cabal that has been subsidized. We've been hearing that there's been the subsidy of petroleum products, especially gasoline. But a lot of people, including Tom David West, said there's no subsidy anywhere. So the idea of even removing or withdrawing something that does not exist is untenable.
Well, I heard a puff of that, but I understand the trend of your question. Something is happening technically. But let me seize the opportunity to say this. This demonstration, this expression of their dissatisfaction goes beyond oil subsidy. When you hear people stick to the original price of oil at the petroleum stations, that figure, in fact, in my view, my study, has become a sort of symbolic expression of everything that has been undergone by the people and which they are no longer interested in tolerating one second longer. We're talking about, for instance, corruption. We're talking about misgovernance. We're talking about the non-fulfillment of promises. We're talking about a distrust that has really reached a peak in the history of the nation. We're talking about the agony that the average family undergoes in making ends meet, with the lack of infrastructure, the impossibility of guaranteeing even modest cottage productivity because of lack of power, lack of fuel, or else the astronomical price which is being placed on raw goods. So we're witnessing something, and I want President and this government to understand that what we're witnessing goes beyond even the petroleum subsidy. We're witnessing a protest against the inordinate amount that is eaten by those who call themselves legislators in the country. So it's a season of total discontent, and it should be handled as such in a holistic manner.
So there's been plenty of protesters, Prof, on the streets of Nigeria since this protest erupted. Many protesters have been killed, about 10 in the last
year. There's definitely a break here. I can hear you faintly in the background.
Okay, can you hear me now, sir?
Repeat what you just said.
Yeah, I was talking about